with me. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Investing.com. Oil prices rose Tuesday, bouncing from the previous session. 9 months low on the likelihood of reduced supply from Hurricane Land and next week OPEC Plus meeting. Bay on 8:55 ET, 12:55 GMT. U.S. crude futures that 19% higher at $78.17 a barrel, while the Brent contract rose 2% to $84.54. Major crude producers are carefully studying the progress of a weather pattern making its way toward the Gulf of Mexico, a region that accounts for about 15% of U.S. crude supply, with the lack of BP and Chevron having already cut production as some offshore oil platform and is currently classified as a category 2 storm and is expected to become a major hurricane within 2 days, making landfall in Florida later this week. This potential disruption of supplies comes ahead of next week's meeting of the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries and Alice, a group known as OPEC+. The group of top producers announced that a modest reduction in output last month in an unsuccessful attempt to set the oil prices light and may be forced into something more substantial this time around. A cutback of up to 1 million barrels may be necessary to tame the downward momentum in prices, analysts at JP Morgan said in a note earlier this month. Crude prices have slipped of late, falling around 15% this month alone, led by a rapidly strengthening dollar and fears of a pronounced economic slowdown as central banks across the globe hiked interest rates to combat soaring inflation. That said, the structural pricing simply set up due to the lack of investment, low spare capacity and inventory has only grown stronger, inevitable requiring much higher prices, analysts at Goldman said in a note Tuesday. The investment bank have commented that investors initiate a long position in the Brent December 24 contract, saying the short-term path to prices is likely to remain volatile, while the USD in the opposite driving seat, but will find our conviction in the long-term bullish view only reinforced by the ongoing global supply disappointment. The American Petroleum Institute released its latest estimate for U.S. crude stock later in the session, with another modest raise expected, will would be the fifth straight weekly raise if confirmed. U.S. stock gained and sterling bonds from this week record low again the dollar on Tuesday, as investors took stock of the recent sharp market move. The Dow Jones Industrial Average, the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq Composite all dead between 1% and 2% after Wall Street fell deeper into a bear market in the previous session. Benchmark 10-year treasury yields they cut up from Monday 12-year hike and the dollar added to 20-year hike on a basket of other currencies. Markets are still worried about the pace of U.S. interest rate raises to calm inflation and concern which has hurt raised assets and boost the U.S. currency. We don't see a quick retrenchment or a return to 2% inflation, keeping the Fed in hiking mode. This implies more volatility and a need for caution and blend in equity allocation. BlackRock stock strategists warned in a note release on Tuesday, in that market are seeing a 74% probability of a further 75 basis point move at the next U.S. Federal Reserve meeting in November. The Fed will need to raise interest rates by at least another percentage point this year, Chicago Fed President Carlos Ivan said on Tuesday, a more aggressive stance that he has previously embraced that under secure the central bank's hardening self to quest to hike inflation. Other central bank speakers due on Thursday include Fed Chair Jerome Powell and European Central Bank President Christine Lagarde. Okay, maybe that's all from me. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.